Good morning, everyone. We're so glad to have you here. It's really wonderful to see so many of you. And some of you I don't necessarily recognize from Tuesday night, but you're so welcome here. We're so glad to see you. And we hope today will be a blessing for you, that you'll have some peace or disturbance, whatever the divine needs for you to have. Just, you know, relax and be silent. So we're going to have three periods of centering prayer this morning. After the first two, we'll have a 5-minute break. Also, we'll have Lectio. We'll have those periods of centering prayer will be followed by Lectio Divina. And then we'll have a third session. And hopefully after the third session, we'll have time for some sharing if you'd like to share. And we'll turn off the recording for the sharing. A couple of housekeeping matters. You're welcome to come and go as you please. But we request that if you leave the gathering, but you know you're coming back, if you could stay in the Zoom room and just turn off your camera and microphone, that makes it easier for the tech host. So I'm going to read a gathering prayer. This is a prayer by Beverly Lanzetta. As we join together this day in the light of your presence, we are reminded that we are all one in the divine heart. May our longing for oneness transform our world. May our gathering together this day signify our hopes for the harmony of our planet, the alleviation of suffering, food for the hungry, shelter for the homeless, and respect for the poor. May this prayer be a testimony of our willingness to commit our lives to the advent of peace, loving all and embracing all in the family of creation. Amen. And just for those who are new, I'm going to go over the basic guidelines for centering prayer. And even for those of us who've been doing it a while, it's good to have a reminder now and then. So the first thing is to choose a sacred word as the symbol of your intention to consent to God's presence and action within. And you could also choose to focus on your, well, not focus, but to center on your breath. Sitting comfortably and with your eyes closed, settle briefly and silently introduce the sacred word or your sacred breath as the symbol of your consent to God's presence and action within. When engaged with your thoughts, return ever so gently to the sacred word. And at the end of the prayer period, remain in silence with eyes closed for a couple of minutes. So we'll begin our first period of centering prayer. Sit with your back straight and your feet flat on the floor or in another stable position. Place your hands on your thighs or in your lap. Gently close your eyes and take a few deep breaths. Notice if there are any adjustments to your posture you'd like to make to be comfortable for the prayer period. And give your body a check to see if you're holding any tensions that you could let go of. Take a moment to notice who God is for you right now, whatever that might mean, and renew your commitment to be open and present to the divine. Silently begin to repeat your sacred word or touch your breath gently with your attention, using your sacred symbol to orient yourself towards God. During the prayer period, whenever you notice that you've become engaged with your thoughts, gently return to the sacred symbol as necessary. And at the end of the prayer period, remain in silence with your eyes closed for a couple of minutes as a way of transitioning from the prayer into daily life. Loving God, we listen for your voice. For our Lectio, I'm going to read a poem called Clearing by Martha Postlethwaite. I'll read it three times with a pause between each reading. And after the third reading, I'll ask you if you'd like to share a word or phrase that was meaningful for you. Do not try to serve the whole world or do anything grandiose. Instead, create a clearing in the dense forest of your life and wait there patiently until the song that is yours alone to sing falls into your open, cupped hands and you recognize and greet it. Only then will you know how to give yourself to the world so worthy of rescue. Do not try to serve the whole world or do anything grandiose. Instead, create a clearing in the dense forest of your life and wait there patiently until the song that is yours alone to sing falls into your open, cupped hands and you recognize and greet it. Only then will you know how to give yourself to the world so worthy of rescue. Do not try to serve the whole world or do anything grandiose. Instead, create a clearing in the dense forest of your life and wait there patiently until the song that is yours alone to sing falls into your open, cupped hands and you recognize and greet it. Only then will you know how to give yourself to the world so worthy of rescue. Now I invite you to share a word or phrase from the poem that was meaningful to you if you'd like, and don't forget to unmute yourself.
Open cupped hands.
Wait patiently.
Recognize.
The song that is yours alone to sing.
Create a clearing.
Wait patiently.
Grandiose.
Recognize and greet it.
Open
song.
into.
The song that's yours alone to sing.
World so worthy of rescue.
Layering in the dense forest of your life.
Open.
Okay, now we'll take a 5-minute break. And when we come back, Modesta will lead our second session of centering prayer.
Welcome back, everyone. Let's continue with this wonderful flow of God's love that we have entered into. And we'll continue with this intercessory prayer. Loving God, we ask for your continued blessings upon this gathering, recognizing that we bring the joys and sorrows of our lives here. If anyone would like to mention silently or aloud prayers of gratitude or concern for loved ones, the dead or dying, the vulnerable and suffering, or anyone who's facing a particular challenge or something that your heart is on your heart, please do so now. And remember to unmute yourself, please, and then remute yourself.
For Joe, Anne, and Annie.
For Kathleen.
For Patty, Paul, and Assad.
For Michael, Richard, and Carol.
For Mary Lee.
For Mike and his family.
For Patrick and Maya.
For my sister and her son.
For remembering my mother, Larice, today.
For Cindy and Malika.
For Bob and Penny.
For Arlene and Naomi.
God, we trust that you hear our prayers, silent or spoken, wordless or in words. Let us begin now our second time of centering prayer. There will be three gongs to begin and three gongs at the end. Sit with your back straight and your feet flat on the ground or in another stable position, your hands on your thighs or in your lap. Gently close your eyes. Take a few deep breaths and notice if there are any adjustments you'd like to be make for the prayer period. Take a moment to notice who God is for you right now, whatever that might mean. Renew your commitment to be open and present to the divine. Silently begin to repeat the sacred word or touch your breath gently with your attention. During the prayer period, whenever you notice that you have become engaged with a thought, gently disengage yourself and return to your sacred word. At the end of the prayer period, remain in silence with your eyes closed for a couple of minutes as a transition to bring your prayer into daily life. Loving God, may we rest in your presence.
Thank you.
Let's transition now into our Lectio reading. I will read a short passage three times, leaving a period of silence after each reading. Try to listen with the ear of your heart. At the end, I will invite you to share a word or phrase from the passage that resonated for you. This passage is from a book entitled The Gift of Prayer by Margaret Silf, S-I-L-F. It's entitled, When I Don't Know What to Say to God. You feel the need for prayer, yet when it comes to the point, you can't put your needs, your feelings, your concerns into words. The good news is our hearts don't need words. They have a language of their own, which is the language of God. If you don't know what to say, say nothing at all. Simply be still with the silence. The time comes for all of us when words fade into silence, and the silence can open us to the presence of God more powerfully than any number of words. Let the eternal word receive your silent yearnings. Listen to the sound of silence. When I don't know what to say to God, you feel the need for prayer, yet when it comes to the point, you can't put your needs, your feelings, your concern into words. The good news is our hearts don't need words. They have a language of their own, which is the language of God. If you don't know what to say, say nothing at all. Simply be still with the silence. The time comes for all of us when words fade into silence, and the silence can open us to the presence of God more powerfully than any number of words. Let the eternal word receive your silent yearnings. Listen to the sound of silence. When I don't know what to say to God, you feel the need for prayer, Yet when it comes to the point, you can put your needs, your feelings, your concerns into words. The good news is our hearts don't need words. They have a language of their own, which is the language of God. If you don't know what to say, say nothing at all. Simply be still with the silence. The time comes for all of us when words fade into silence, and the silence can open us to the presence of God more powerfully than any number of words. Let the eternal word receive your silent yearnings. Listen to the sound of silence. I invite you now to share a word or phrase from the passage that resonated for you.
Listen.
I don't know.
Silent yearning.
This is the good news.
Our hearts don't need words.
Words fade into silence.
Simply be still.
Silent yearnings. Listen to the silence.
Now we have a second 5-minute break, and we'll see you back here in 5 minutes.
third period of centering prayer. Lord, we adore you, present in our inmost being and among us. Draw us inwardly by the greatness of your love so that we might taste that peace that surpasses all understanding, and that little by little we might understand what it means to be lived in by God. Heal the wounds of a lifetime, body, soul, and spirit, as we wait lovingly upon your presence and healing action within us.
Now we will engage in an Ignatian guided meditation period. Ignatian meditation is a way of praying that uses visualization to invite us into a gospel story. I'm going to read a gospel passage two times with silence in between. Allow yourself to be very present to the events in the passage as they unfold. Pay attention to all the details, the sights, sounds, smells, tastes, and sensations of the scene taking place around you. After I've finished reading the passage two times, I will offer you some instructions that will invite you to engage with the story in creative, possibly surprising ways, allowing the story to unfold anew. The scene does not have to play out in the way it did in the gospel reading, and you don't have to worry about historical accuracy or physical plausibility. You can allow yourself the freedom of imagination to let the meditation play out in whatever way you wish. Offer your prayer time to the Holy Spirit and trust that your imagination and the Spirit will collaborate to create something that is meaningful and illuminating for you. This is a passage from Matthew. As Jesus was walking beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon called Peter, and his brother Andrew. They were casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. "Come, follow me," Jesus said, "and I will send you out to fish for people." At once, they left their nets and followed him. Going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, preparing their nets. Jesus called them, and immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him.
As Jesus was walking beside the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, called Peter, and his brother Andrew. They were casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. "Come, follow me," Jesus said, "and I will send you out to fish for people." At once they left their nets and followed him. Going on from there, he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. They were in a boat with their father Zebedee, preparing their nets. Jesus called them, and immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. Now imagine that you are right in the story as it is happening. The scene does not have to unfold the way it did in the reading, and you don't have to worry about historical or physical accuracy. This is your meditation, and it can play out in whatever way you wish. Take all the time you need to place yourself in the setting, in vivid detail, with all five of your senses. You may be one of the people in the story, or you may be someone who isn't mentioned in the story. Or you may be something in the story that isn't a person. Who or what are you? Where are you? Look around. What does the scene look like? Notice the weather. How does the air around you feel? What smells are in the air? What sounds do you hear? What draws your attention in this setting? Are there people near you? What do they look like? How are they dressed? How do you feel about them? What are you doing, or what would you like to do? What emotions do you feel in this scene? Notice and experience what happens as the situation continues. And now, the others have all gone away, and only Jesus is left. He sees you, he welcomes you, and he invites you to sit down and talk with him. If you could ask him or tell him something about your own life or about your experience in this scene, what would it be? Could you ask him or tell him now and hear what he says to you? Now, make whatever preparations you need to leave the scene. Say goodbye, knowing that you can come back whenever you choose. I invite you to share a word or phrase that describes your experience of the meditation.
Go live life well. I will always be with you.
Called.
Poignant and powerful.
Awakening.
Provocative.
Hope.
Want to serve.
Invitation and response.
Trust, reassured, loved.
Let go.
Dappling. follow me.
Leave.
Now we'll close with Mary leading us in the prayer of Jesus, and then we'll turn off the recording. And those of you who would like to could stay for a few more minutes to share what the morning was like for you.
Ground of all being, mother of life, father of the universe, your name is sacred beyond speaking. May we know your presence. May your longings be our longings in heart and in action. May there be food for the human family today and for the whole earth community. Forgive us the falseness of what we have done, as we forgive those who are untrue to us. Do not forsake us in our time of conflict, but lead us into new beginnings. For the light of life, the vitality of life, and the glory of life are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Well, thank you so much for being with us.